Hello, hello, and welcome to Great Builds for Greatsword, where I showcase all of the builds that I use most frequently in my hunts. The topic of today's showcase is a build that I like to call the Rebuker. This build is intended to achieve the highest amount of damage possible with the addition of providing extra attack power against monsters who insist on dealing some kind of aura damage. As such, this set is very useful to hunt the likes of Teostra or Savage Deviljoe. Drawing power from damage and resolve from pain, this build will make your greatsword be greater in the face of adversity. Here is the complete breakdown. My weapon of choice is the Saffy Shatter Splitter. The greatsword that Saffy gives us are some of the best weapons we have access to, and I personally consider them to be the very best. For this reason, you will see them in most of my builds, if not all of them. For the awakenings of this weapon, we are going full attack. That means 4 instances of attack 5 and 1 instance of attack 6. As for its augmentations, we are taking 1 attack up and 1 health regen. Please note that you could add in another attack up and 1 status up instead of health regen. This will give you a bit more damage, but in my opinion, health regen is the way to go as it is too valuable for great swords. Moving on to the armor, we will be using the following pieces: Alatrion Helm A, Damascus Chest B, Frost Fang Gloves B, Raging Brachy Waist B, Raging Brachy Legs B. Using these 5 armor pieces gives us access to 2 different set bonuses: Agitator Secret for more damage and affinity, and then Punishing Draw for greater damage opportunities. To finish off our equipment, we need the Attack Charm 5, the Rocksteady Mantle, and the Impact Mantle. As you can see, the Rocksteady Mantle is suited with 2 Medicine Jewels for additional health regen, and the Impact Mantle is fitted with 2 KO Jewels to increase our stun potential. All of this equipment is fitted with the following decorations: on the greatsword, 1 critical vitality; on the helmet, 1 tenderizer jewel and 1 expert jewel; on the chest, 1 challenger plus, 1 charger jewel and 1 expert jewel; on the gloves, 2 critical vitality jewels; on the waist, 1 furor plus jewel and 1 expert jewel; on the legs, 1 challenger plus jewel, 1 attack jewel, and another attack jewel. Unfortunately, this build is very decoration intensive. Many of these decorations are of the highest rarity to obtain. 2 challenger pluses and 3 critical vitalities alongside 1 furor plus means that a lot of good RNG is required. This is something that is unavoidable when creating this set, as we need to squeeze out every bit of efficiency from our pieces and decorations in order to fit all of the skills required to reach the maximum amount of damage possible. With all of the pieces in their place, we will be hunting with the following skills: Attack Boost 7, Critical Eye 7, Agitator 7, Resentment 5, Health Boost 3, Critical Boost 3, Weakness Exploit 3, Focus 3, and then Recovery Up 2 and Slugger 2 as inactive skills depending on when we use our mantles. As mentioned before, the objective with this build is to reach the highest amount of damage possible. To this effect, we are able to stack all of the standard DPS skills while adding Resentment as our conditional buff. This build is geared towards fighting Teostra by counteracting his fire aura. Once we get close enough to attack him, the damage over time aura will initiate the Resentment and give us a hefty power boost. In this situation, using health regen might sound counterproductive, but in reality, The nature of the damage over the time makes it so that we immediately take damage after being healed, which initiates resentment once again. We are able to obtain the benefit of the healing without losing the big power boost. Now, let's go over the positives and the negatives of using this particular build. The number one pro of this set is the amount of damage that it deals. Being able to take advantage of all of the damage skills plus resentment when it is activated means that the damage numbers on the screen are gonna be very large. Also, we are able to get the benefits of health boost 3 and focus 3 on top of the high raw power. This makes the build relatively comfortable to use too. In regards to cons, it is important to mention that this is a specific build fit for a specific purpose, that is, to counteract damage over time auras. Using this set against other monsters is not going to be as efficient. Another negative thing is the need for so many high rarity decorations. A lot of grinding is needed in order to make this build. Finally, I need to touch on the subject of sharpness. With only 40 hits of white sharpness, it should be enough to deal with most situations. That said, sharpening will be necessary, and I highly recommend that you stock up on Wetfish Plus scales. This set has allowed me to optimize my Teostra hunts and bring them to the next level. I hope that it is also useful for you to bring down this Elder Dragon as efficiently as possible. I would like to thank you for your time. I wish that you have a wonderful day, and please remember to use more greatsword.